Jeez, we look like we're going.
What do we think we have? What for?
Master Faithful, how's the trouble shaping structure going?
Much better now than I have Master Peter to help me. Although to be quite honest, it's more a case of me helping him.
Next time round, you'll be the siege master.
I rather hope there won't be.
How's work going with Master Peter?
Excellent. His knowledge of machinery and mechanics is absolutely astonishing. He's a very good man.
So you're confident the Trebuchet will do its job?
Absolutely. It's great to see Master Peter is exactly as he's doing.
How much knowledge have you got to the
I would like to hazard a guess. As I understand, the base is critical to make, but the other parts are more complex. And then there's all the balancing and setting the trajectory and range.
Well, I hope it's going to
so do I, guy.
You're right.
I gotta wait till the siege engine is moved on at hand.
Thank you. Let's see how strong those walls are.
Sir, they're coming. There's no time.
Someone bring water. Breathe. It'll be all right.
Who's coming?
There's an army on the way. And they're carrying the colors of Havel Medic of Valde. And they're very close.
Havel Medic.
Sure, sir.
Not that.
I have a score to see.
Really, I want to finish this game and move on. God damn it.
Gentlemen, top reinforcements are about to descend on us. We don't know exactly. There are men. Probably be here by 5.
So soon? How is it that you knew nothing about this before?
The whole land is in chaos. It's a wonder we can find out anything.
If they attack out of here,
we'd be finished. Just as far as we can.
If one step ahead is the whole time.
Not this time.
What are you thinking?
Robot, how do you think the weather might be?
Sir, my joints don't cease.
Rain
comes.
Here. We'll make a stand. I am that dismissal. You will wait until they charge us. Strike them from the rear. Here. We succeed. Over and done with before they notice anything.
Right. I will have time for some
sound. Human, we are on.
Let the men pin you the most out. We don't even know how many there are.
We will hold out.
I'll give you all the order.
My partner.
I want to discuss that. I need more than that.
If we can't hold out, you, I, Tanish, and I.
And since Tanish is commanding the flank point, Radzik is captain, I'm wounded. Captain Robot will be leading up.
Of course, investigate.
There's no question of Robot's position. But many of them have been scouted. We need someone there who knows them as their resource.
Sir.
I mean you.
But that is.
Sir, you wouldn't take on something. And if it weren't for you, we wouldn't even be here. In the battle, you and the group of scholars will be concealed in the woods until we get the word.
Sir, I think I should.
Quiet. Don't underestimate us. We'll have to keep nervous men on the short shore and then conduct the attack on the rear so seriously and quickly. Have no clue if the line should stop. We need these with their head pen. Very well, that's what I'm saying. When you're ready, then they'll be mustering in the woods above the river.
If you go Don't you know them?
I should kill you.
What?
Oh, great.
And I'm gonna get robbed. Or am I? Actually, I have stitches.
Not yet. Hold. Easy. Just a little more.
Ishtvan. Not Sir Ishtvan, or Lord Thoth. Just how intimate are the two? He's Eric, Thoth's captain and right-hand man. Finally, some good news. Shackle, guarding place.
Those bastards want to destroy our trebuchet!
Really? You're being a little bitch? Stand still. God, I hate
the damage isn't too much.
So is the shoes.
Not us yet.
Sir, what are you waiting for?
You've heard his threat. You want him to kill Radzik and my wife? You have to consider all our options.
And it would be a shame to destroy the castle, too. How do we get that crap out?
Sir, I might have solutions.
What about exchanging messages?
He was the captain of Zandar. He brought Ishtar's reinforcements here. Seems to be on very intimate terms with Toth. He might be able to tell us something. He might even be as valuable to his lord as Lady Stephanie and my father are to us.
Your father's son.
Your godson. Right. We'll interrogate this force. Then decide what to do. Come to my tavern.
You need to change your tone. If you start doing this, the merchants will not let us alone. So now I'll ask you a few questions, and you better think carefully about how you answer them. Who is this Turk?
Presumably the same as me. The Turks killed his parents, so he started killing Turks. Sigismund needed me, so Istvan ended up in his service.
How did you meet him?
It's thanks to that guy.
What is he after?
Are you really that trap?
Who does he take his orders
from? Are you stupid?
How many men is it?
There were nearly 7,000. But it's probably more than half. But that's still more than there.
Listen to me. Toth has hostages in the camp. You'd better brave my ill for your own sake. Because once we attack, you'll be worthless to us. And what do you suppose will happen? I won't waste any more time on you. You could have saved yourself, but apparently you valued...
I don't need to save myself. Istvan will save me.
Why should we save him? You're sacrificing, just like everyone in Granit and Pribislav. You're nothing but a common band.
You don't know anything.
Now I'm curious. Why would you know that much about it?
You never understand that.
For a while, I thought we'd get nothing out of that. In the end,
I thought you were much too much.
I think the time has come to find out just how much Toth values our hostage. You have a parley with him yourself?
I think I'll leave that to you.
So be it, then. Do my utmost. Bring the hostage below the battlements.
We know they're alive. I didn't expect much of that.
He won't harm us.
Well, friends, what do you suggest?
I'd say we have no choice but to attack.
It's a great risk we're on. But Stephanie and Mads have been sent.
I know how you feel, sir. The top is no fool. They are his last safeguard. You will do nothing to harm them until you're sure.
Would you be saying that if it were your wife inside?
Father?
Well, let me point out that we have no choice anyway. We don't have enough supplies to keep men here for weeks, while gangs of brigands and Sigismund's army roam the countryside. Toth won't agree to an exchange, and even if he did, we'd have to let him go. All his men would be a thorn in our sides till judgment day.
Sir, a message has arrived.
Well, what is it?
Margrave Yorks is approaching with his retinue and wants to speak with you.
Yorks? Right.
What's he doing?
Who's Jobst? Jobst of Luxembourg, his cousin to King Wenceslas, and citizen. He's the Margrave of Moravia.
Only a year ago, he was collaborating with Sigismund in the League of Lords. He betrayed King Wenceslas and his ally proper. Now, he's changed sides, appointed himself the leader of the rebellion against Sigismund, and wants to liberate Wenceslas. Nevertheless, seems a decision is made for us. We don't want the Yorks camping with us in front of our own castle like a band of gypsies.
I'm afraid you're right, Hodge. All right. We'll let the men rest a while and then attack. Come to me when everything is ready.
Alright, hopefully I'm almost done with the silly game.
I'm glad to play.
At your service, sir.
I'm about to put the order for Bombard and Calmar.
And since it's mainly thanks to you, we still have a challenge.
With an oyster.
To smash my glasses.
Can you say I'm sure you're enthusiastic?
Sorry, sir. Give me a minute. There's nothing to it. The men will know the truth. All you have to do is pull the lever.
I suppose I could notice that.
Then we were on Bard Calmar for several days. Sir Robard Bard explained what comes next.
Yeah, I've always wanted to fire a trebuchet.
Load the trebuchet!
There was precious little in here, look at it.
That's how it goes on here. The gods stood by us. In the end, they're nothing but a bunch of filthy cutthroats.
Well, they're out to wait till a man nips off into the bushes to remove himself, lifts up his chainmail tunic and stab him in the back. Personally, I'd rather face a proper soldier.
Because you know just who you're up against. That's probably why Tom is giving us such a hard time.
Is something the matter?
A few of them have taken to their heels. If they stop in Hindenburg, I'll be glad of that. But I fear if you did.
Those were the best of this man's men. They could be lurking under the roof. They'll probably wait to attack us at the worst possible moment.
My fear exactly. I won't breathe until Toth is hanging from the gate. But in the meantime, I'll be...
Good, sir. Would you like me to bring back their gear as evidence of their death?
That's not necessary. I trust you. You don't even have to do the killing. Just let me know where you find them.
You came just in time?
Right. I thought my last son had come. But Lord Capon came to our defense and fought like a lion. I'd say he's growing into it.
I think more people will be changing their mind.
They should. I owe them.
For a few days, or if you have anything to attend to.
You're in the wrong place at the time.
What's the matter? Come on!
Lord Doran.
We made it in the nick of it.
We failed. That serpent from Valdic gave us the slip. Should have known we had to be the
would you?
Maybe. But before that, I throw him in the dungeon for a few people and see how much he did. Still, just make him get to me.
I found the pilot.
Well done, though. Tell me. I'm here.
Can't you see with your one point?
I'm here.
no time yet.
I'm here.
Can't you see with your...
Commander. Fucker.
Since Sedivus' colors fell on fire at the time, I suppose it will.
Just so.
I did.
All right. When did he start?
There's no reason to. Are you really ready? You won't have another chance to.
I have to deal with it.
All right, man.
Do it in the morning. Start the siege now.
God, God be with me.
Are we prepared? There's no reason. You won't have another chance.
I'm ready.
We're going to attack on two fronts. The north gate and the west wall, which will scale with ladders. The attack will be split into different stages. Take the outer wall, the inner main, and finally the core of the castle on the tower.
How are we going to attack the tower?
We try to do as much damage as we can to Trebuchet. He's a plain technique, right? Even if that's true, we'll have to charge through a downpour of enemy arrows all the way to the port.
Oh, thanks.
Fortunately, it's wooden, so we'll be able to break it down. It's dealing with the defense of the Bailey.
And what's the plan for attacking?
First, we have to get men to the wall, which is no easy matter to fight. So we'll need as many men covering them as possible. As soon as the ladders are in place, our foot soldiers will run up and try to scale the wall. Once a few of them get to the battle map, we should quickly gain the other hand.
How will we take them?
Either by scaling the west wall, where our men are headed.
And the inner gate?
That will be tough. Even if you get through the gate, the castle is designed so we'll be like hens on a coop. To anyone with a bow, we'll have to either fight our way through.
What about the middle?
There are where most of us are. Once we're inside, Ishban will know defeat is inevitable.
I think I've heard everything.
You want to join the attack on the walls or on the gate? Remember, many of the skeletons will follow you.
I'll help with the attack on the walls.
I'm proud of you. You've changed from insolent top, and as God is my witness.
A village lad and an old soldier.
If he's not right, just one last time. No matter how good, keep your eyes on it. Take advantage of every chance. Help your comrade. You have to take the castle back.
I remember that.
Good luck to you.
Good luck to you, old soldier.
I swear it is.
Run!
Some help will be nice, gentlemen.
Thank you.
Really? Yeah, what? Doesn't feel good now, does it?
sir. We should be sure.
See if Ishvan Toth can work his way out of this one. Don't tempt fate, Yamash.
Ishvan! It's over! You want us to come and get you?
I wouldn't advise that. Your friend Dimish wants to see his wife alive again.
Sir Radzik? Are both hostages unharmed?
Now, Anush, unless circumstances change.
I'm glad to hear it. My guest is also safe and sound, but he's also quite keen to go home. I imagine he feels the same way. It's been a long time since you warmed yourself at your own heart.
I'm in no hurry. I've plenty of supplies here. Grand view and exit. What more can I want?
The freedom!
Freedom? Freedom to get an arrow in the back?
Sir, your nobleman here, all bound by honor, I give you my word as a knight and lord, and that of my companions. If you release Lady Stephanie and Sir Redzin, you may leave the castle with your men and go on your way unharmed.
Just how far will we get? What good will it do me if your men attack us in the woods instead of here?
If you give me your word of honor that you will leave and never return, I promise you safe passage to the boundary of this field. What happens after that is up to you and the will of God Almighty.
Very well then, but I want a small safety. I'll give you her ladyship. But Radzik comes with me. I'll release him in scuds.
Out of the question! Is our word not good enough for you?
Is mine not good enough for you? I swear I'll release him when I get to a safe distance.
I'll go with him, Anush. Let the Lady Stephanie have her freedom now.
Father!
Don't worry, son. I trust Lord Toth's self-interest more than his word. He wouldn't be fool enough to harm me.
If you're certain, Radzik,
prepare horses and supplies, and tell your men to pull back. We'll come down.
You heard me. Get to work. And any man who breaks his truce answers to me.
So, are you really going to let them go?
My word is my bond, Henry.
He's a cutthroat and a liar. Good men are dead because of him. What's to stop us from skewering him as soon as he sets foot outside?
Our honor.
If you let him go, he'll do the same again.
Or worse, God's justice. Then,
if we bring our glory of honor, we have him. And without our honor, we are nothing.
Never fear. Your father will be all right. We'll hunt on this.
Bring the horses.
Here she is, as I promised. Not a hair on her.
Definitely.
The memento.
This isn't over. I'll find you.
I look forward to it.
Yeah!
happens. We have to see which way they go. We really are heading for Scathids.
Mount up, Henry. You've heard what he'll do if you follow him.
I'm not going to follow him. I just need to collect your father.
But he wanted to walk back here and release us.
I was an apprentice blacksmith. What a term.
Say different, you silly bugger. The way you have found Cobb, sneaking into Bradley and Willow Grove. Well, Cobb, what I mean is, hats off to you, man. Wouldn't catch me doing that.
Truth is, I didn't think much about it. I just felt I had to.
Yeah.
No sign of them. Move on.
Glad to see Ishban kept his word, sir.
Not half as glad as I am, Your Grace.
Well, we kept our word too. Now Toff has had his head start and he's fair game. Which way do they go?
To the north, but I would be careful, sir.
Fear not, Your Grace. Twice as many men as he. Well, I won't keep you any longer. I'm sure the few of you have a lot to say to each other. Let's go!
All right, Fly.
I am. They treated me quite decently. Although they did steal my horse, so I have to go back.
It looks like it's all over.
Not quite long. It won't be over until we get this mess out of
the caps that faster. How can we let him go?
Would you rather we killed him? Even if it meant Lady Steffi and I died too.
Of course it was. And what was to stop us from killing him after the exchange?
Honor.
Honor.
the word of honor of a nobleman would not be trusted, then he would never have agreed to the exchange.
There is an honor in the banner on your side.
No hopes. You're young, huh? Happy. I couldn't marry a cradle. And your father, Martha, came alone and took care of both of them.
You?
What? That was your father, sir.
He was a great man.
He took care of his father. I always kept nine. I'm sure.
And there's so little about his past.
I told you all that. Oddly enough, even though you don't have his blood, you're very lucky. When he was around your age, he became bored of his trade and set out to see the world. He lived through many adventures, even fought in a war.
War?
Yes, in Poland.
And I don't think he cared much for it. That's why he wanted me to stay at home.
He spent some time in Prague, and then settled in Gutenberg. It seems he quarreled with someone there and finally ended up here. You know the rest.
I loved it, even so. But somehow I always had a feeling I didn't quite fit in.
It was in your blood, also.
I must have been the only one I left for you. Your sword.
The sword. Not my fault. It's yours. For a moment, I was so near yet so far. I can't help it.
It was almost within my grasp, but I guess then I'll have something else.
Well, I think we may yet have a chance to get it back. This business with the top is not yet over.
Unfortunately, there's a chance of blood. Not just to get the sword, but that bastard is trying to. And then I'll find that German horse with the torch scallops and I'll slay him again. I'll never forget his face. There is no. Mark Vark von Alvarez.
With a noble intention, but don't forget there are other things in this world that are worth living for. Look around you. Blue skies overhead, green grass underfoot, beautiful girls. Good wine. A few good friends and a fine steed under your backside. Those are the ones we need. You can find what your mother's killed for. It doesn't have to grow so much. It has to hold it on.
On the subject of steeds,
to ride like the Knights Templar.
How's that?
Two up. One day I'll tell you how they got their suit. You can take the front. It's like I was imagining touching my boy to the head. Although it would be better than this. Word, it's like a ghost today, isn't it? I wonder who this is.
I know. It's Margrave Herbst.
King's cousin. I wonder what he wants. I guess we'll find out soon enough.
Yeah, baby.
Good fucking lord, finally.
Someone has to leave and carry the torch. That's what it's saying. It's just a thing. I'm going to be fine for it. No, no. Standing up to leave me the same as someone says. Thank you.
I should really get beer and a one cut.
With Margaret
Ross
as well.
I am.
What about his chance?
Assuming you that we didn't catch him?
No.
Because if he had, he'd be the first one to know.
No fear. Get him eventually.
I hope you're right.
Anyway, let's see what he wants.
My lord,
Christ and blessings on you.
And on you, Lord Capley.
And this is my son, Henry.
I didn't know you had a son, Sir Renton.
Heaven's head of surprise to young Henry, too.
This gentleman here is John II of Lichtenstein, a member of my council.
I'm honored, gentlemen.
Come join us. Margaret Johnson just about to tell us the reason for his visit. Great.
I'm sure we're all agreed, Your Graces, that all this unrest must come to an end. This kingdom needs a king.
Question is, which king?
My cousin, Wenceslas IV, who is being held in captivity.
I have to confess, my lord, that your answer surprises me a little. If I'm correct, four wars in this city, you decided on your other than the sixth.
I cannot deny, and I have always stated my position plainly. But times have changed.
How have changed,
sir? There is one thing on which we undoubtedly concur: that King Wenceslas, unfortunately, did not inherit his father's gift for governor. Sadly, his failures have cost Bohemia, the nobles, and our whole Luxembourg family a great deal of money and effort.
How did a king let it go so far, Captain?
It's in his temper. Cares only for wine, women, and the hunt. King, in fact, who never wanted to be king.
Why didn't he just let his brother have the crown?
Young sir, the crown weighs heavy when there are duties to perform. Surrendering means giving up great privileges, too.
But he did surrender power to his brother. Things started getting out of hand. Wenceslas appealed to Sigismund for help in restoring the world.
What you're saying, Wenceslas invited him here?
Actually, it makes sense when you think. Sigismund wanted to re-establish the power of the old House of Luxembourg. He thought if he helped Wenceslas win the imperial crown, in return his brother would help him become the king of the world. And the actual reign of Lord Union. And they are going to live. Sigismund's golden, while Wenceslas will carry on doing what he was best at, enjoying the life of the imperial court.
Why wasn't Wenceslas crowned Holy Roman Emperor long ago? He's already elected king of the Romans. All he had to do is go get the Pope with the damn imperial crown on his head.
Who knows? Maybe he'd prefer hunting and consulting with bathhouse wenches to spending time with the Pope.
Yeah, so would I, honestly.
Sigismund's plan seemed soundless, but it didn't quite work out, did it?
It worked for a while. He and his brother reached an agreement. Sigismund took over administration of the kingdom and began planning Wenceslas' journey to Rome for the imperial coronation. But then Wenceslas realized he would just be a puppet.
I must say, my brother, Wenceslas' brother, not his children needed good clothing up here.
Sigismund would agree. He was already planning his rule of Bohemia, and all of a sudden, the rug was pulled from under him. I'd say he lost his patience and decided he'd drag Wenceslas to the coronation kicking and screaming if he had to. Just like a naughty child.
So he abducted him and your brother Trapup too, if I hear you correct.
Correct.
And you helped him do it, if I heard correctly.
Yes, your grace, it's true. I was there when Sigismund abducted Trapup. I thought everything could somehow be settled, that we could make my brother success. But Sigismund just wanted to put an end to the dispute once and for all, whatever the cost. There was nothing I could do to stop him. And that's one of the reasons why I'm here. The worst of it is that it was all for nothing. Instead of putting a stop to the revolt, it escalated it, and the result is this chaos we have today.
That's true enough, sir. I must admit now, I'm not sure what your position is. The king is incompetent, but we must protect him.
The simple truth, General, is that for all of Wenceslas' faults, we have no one else. We do as I do.
Like it, though.
But what can we do? Sigismund has the League of Lords, Otto von Bergold, Heinrich von Rosenberg.
Now, even the nobles of the League of Lords will realize that Sigismund's essence is not a chance.
So now, Berghoff is on your side. I wish to assemble an army together with him and face Sigismund and fear the battle.
And that might be such a fear as may be so as elegant. Now, the necessities of hostility and his own experience. I have negotiated an alliance. I'm very ambitious. I wish and of course the check. Against. Every day he is losing the ground up into his head. That's why I want your help too.
What kind of help, Paul? Sigismund has a massive army. Rosenberg, Berghoff, and Prague are behind him. Do you have an army you can face him with?
But that's not what I mean at all. There's been a revolt against Sigismund. And now he'll have to choose whether he wants to gain the Bohemian crown, which is a very risky enterprise, or hold on to the Hungarian one. He can't have both. And there's a tough struggle awaiting him in Hungary. I'm not sure he'll win. And Rosenberg and Berghoff, no. They're not stupid. If the Bohemian nobility stands together, they will turn.
We are men of the council. Radzik here lost everything because he was alive with Wenceslas. Divish painted in a hair of the same feather. Even rats have defenses against Sigismund and the League of Lords.
What's more, your Grace, King Wenceslas languishes in captivity in Vienna. He can't rule too well from there.
And what do you propose? To sit with your arms folded until the Bohemian lands are turned to ashes like scallops? We have to put a stop to this senseless war!
Yeah.
Do you know, sir, what the true position of the League of Lords is?
I'm not on the best of terms with them at this moment, so you'll have to ask them yourselves.
Yes. The Fjords. I'll go and visit Berger at his castle and we'll see what he tells us.
That's not such a bad idea, sir.
True. A little risky.
I doubt Berghoff will harm the new company, boy. And you can find out what he has to say about developers. But the League of Lords is planning.
Yeah, it's fine. Come on.
I'd like to know.
Why not? He's proven himself an able investigator. And he'll also be a good bodyguard.
Send Sir John here to be my eyes. I believe both your reports will help us get a better grip on the situation.
When can you send out?
Just as soon as our partner thinks.
Excellent. I'll bring Lord Sly and craft him. Get ready. We'll meet back here.
Yeah. Come here.
What?
Quite so.
Come on, yeah, girl. Inside. What? Good girl. I have to go to work.